adventurer.
Adventure Game Geek, this is Roberta Williams.
Adventure Game Geek, solving riddles great and small. Adventure Game Geek,
adventure games, he loves them all. Every day is a new quest, exploring north, south, east, or west. Point and click to find the answers that we seek. Adventure Game Geek.
Hello there, fellow spelunkers. It's time to delve into the depths of Colossal Cave, the latest adventure from Ken and Roberta Williams. And if you don't know who they are, you've most likely been living in a cave. As every adventurer knows, they're the legendary founders of Sierra Online, and they've come out of retirement to bless us with another game, this time under their new company, Cygnus Entertainment, named after their boat which they've sailed around the world on. It feels like they've come full circle, as they decided to make a 3D reimagining of the original Colossal Cave text adventure by Will Crowther and Don Woods, which inspired Roberta Williams to take up game design. There's a playable version of it on the Colossal Cave 3D website, complete with a vintage Apple monitor, because that's the most authentic way to play a text adventure like this. Or better yet, with no monitor at all, using a mainframe computer connected to a teleprinter.
But that's another story for more retro tech geeks. I'm just here to chew bubblegum and play adventure games. And I'm all out of bubblegum.
This review is for the PC version of Colossal Cave, but it's also available on various other platforms, including VR, which I tried out for the first time at PAX West last year, and was totally rubbish at it, despite producer Marcus Murrah teaching me the controls.
Wait, am I back at the entrance or what? Where am I?
I think you're back at the entrance.
Oh.
Original developer Will Crowther was an avid spelunker, and the layout of the cave system was inspired by the Mammoth Cave in Kentucky. I traveled there all the way from England to find out more.
Hello there, fellow adventurers. I'm here at the Mammoth Cave in Kentucky.
Kentucky? We're in West Wickham at the Hellfire Caves.
No, we're not. We're in Kentucky.
West Wickham?
Kentucky.
Hellfire Caves.
Mammoth Cave.
Hellfire. Cave.
Mammoth.
Welcome to the Hellfire Caves in West Wickham, a unique underground adventure for those brave enough to explore its winding passages. On your way, you'll encounter those who came here before, including Benjamin Franklin and members of the infamous Hellfire Club. Read all about their dubious activities, including the hilarious story of how Lord Sandwich was attacked by a baboon dressed as the devil. The caves are said to be haunted, so watch out for ghosts which could be lurking in the shadows. It's a fun day out for all the family, and kids will especially love the children's cave with these creepy statues. Will you make it as far as the River Styx and cross over into the Inner Temple, where the Hellfire Club got up to their most secret shenanigans? And will you ever find your way out again?
From the very first words, this is very much a faithful adaptation of the original.
You are standing at the end of a road before a small brick building. Around you is a forest. A small stream flows out of the building and down a gully.
There's a score in the top left corner, and as you can see, we've already got 27 out of 350. So we must have solved a few puzzles already before getting here. Inside the building are some items that are essential to our adventure.
There is a bottle of water here. There is food here. There is a shiny brass lamp nearby.
The voiceover narration by Jason Cryer is brilliant, so much so that it makes even the most mundane items seem extraordinary.
Set of keys. Tasty food. Bottle of water. Set of keys. Bottle of water. Tasty food.
Following the stream down from the building, we discover a grate which is the entrance to the cave, with an owl sitting on a nearby tree watching over it. King's Quest fans will immediately think of Cedric and imagine this owl could talk.
Greetings, friend owl. Is this the entrance to Colossal Cave?
Oh, you're crazy to go down into that dark hole. You don't know what's down there.
I'm afraid I must. Won't you come with me?
No, mind if I wait for you here?
What do you mean by that?
Graham, watch out! A poisonous snake!
Once inside the cave, it's too dark to see, so we turn on our lantern, and from this point on, we're on the clock. In other words, the lantern runs on batteries, though it looks like one of those old-fashioned ones that uses oil. And once the batteries run out, we'll be left in the dark again.
My goodness, that was a mighty fall.
When you start a new game, it asks if you'd like instructions, and this is actually a crucial choice, as it affects both your score and how long your lantern will last. You wouldn't know this, though, until the latest patch to the game, which explains it all, just like Clarissa. And yes, I made that joke in my very first review of Rhea Face the Unknown.
Done.
So after all that dooziness, the core machine is activated, and the alchemist appears one last time to explain it all, just like Clarissa.
What is it like to be dealing with such a powerful, terrible mind?
What's it like? I'll tell you what it's like. It's just a normal day in the life of an adventure gamer. The first time you play the game, it's highly recommended to read the instructions, as you'll have much more time to explore, and you'll need all the time you can get if you want to uncover everything the cave has to offer. The objective is to find all the treasures and bring them back to the well house, which sounds simple enough, but it won't be as easy as taking candy from a baby. More like taking treasure from a bunch of knife-wielding dwarves.
There is a threatening dwarf. A sharp knife is thrown.
Every time a dwarf attacks, there's a chance their knife will find its mark. So, as a wise adventurer once said,
save early, save often.
Not all the dwarves want to kill you, though. Some just jump into the ground and disappear. I'm not entirely sure how they managed to do this. I guess they're a special breed of earth-burrowing dwarves, kinda like the Graboids in Tremors.
Must be a million of them! Nope, just one!
Dwarves are not the only inhabitants of the cave. In this chamber, called the Hall of the Mountain King, we run into a snake barring our way. There's actually a way to sneak past the snake, but you're really supposed to figure out how to get rid of it for good. The first time I played the game was during the beta testing, where I found out the trouble you can get into by trying to cheat the snake. One time I managed to get stuck inside it and could look right into its fiery eyes. Another time I fell into this pit of vipers and miraculously survived, and could see a desert landscape stretching away beyond the walls. Is that the endless desert in King's Quest V?
Dying for a drink, Graham?
Dying for a drink? Ha ha ha.
There's even a special dialogue for bugs that fingers crossed you'll never get to hear.
Oops. You hit some bug that we are going to pretend is an undocumented feature. Our sincere apologies. As you can imagine, we are seeking the culprit, and we'll deal with them appropriately.
Before too long, you'll have collected a few treasures and want to drop them off for safekeeping. Here's where the famous magic words Zizzy and Plu come into play, which in the right place will teleport us back to the well house.
Plu, you feel a strange pulling sensation.
Where have I heard that before?
Alexander feels a strange pulling sensation.
Then it's back to the cave to look for more treasure. Unlike most adventure games where you can stuff an infinite number of items down your pants, there's a limit to what you can carry. This makes the game more challenging as you have to think carefully about which objects you need to take with you. Fortunately, any items you drop are displayed on the auto map, which is meticulously designed and is essential if you're not going old school and drawing your own. And really, who's that hardcore these days?
Hi, I'm Robot Spacer. So leading up to the release of Colossal Cave Reimagined, I decided it was time to finally play the original text adventure game. Having grown up on text adventure games, I knew it was pretty important to draw a map. And then when Reimagined came out, of course I brought my maps along to see how accurate they were. I was pretty delighted to discover that everything was very much the same, and I was able to navigate even the complex mazes using my original maps. This is the All Alike maze. And the All Different maze. This looks pretty chaotic, but I was able to use this and get through the mazes in just a few moves. Everything was exactly how I expected it to be.
Wow, that's pretty hardcore.
Even with the map, it's easy to get lost, especially as some exits don't always take you where you expect. For example, in what's called the Bedquilt Room, this passage seems like it only takes you back to where you started.
You've crawled around in some little holes and wound up back in the main passage.
But sometimes it leads to this room with a giant skeleton.
How would you go about carrying those huge bones? Ridiculous.
And if you're really lucky, it'll take you to this secret canyon that you'd otherwise have missed, which would be a shame as you wouldn't get to see these giant crystals, or this swirling vortex that looks totally safe to climb down into. There's also a dwarf here who's too busy knitting to pay any attention to us. This would have been a great opportunity for some NPC interaction, which is one of the things I felt was missing from the game, along with some good old Sierra-style deaths, as you can walk right up to the snake and even this dragon without getting killed.
Come on, kill me! Kill me, I'm here! Kill me!
I'm here! Kill me!
Come on, kill me! I'm here!
Despite the fact that there's a time limit, or rather a turn limit, as each action takes up a turn, it's worth taking the time to appreciate the caves, like stopping to admire the beautifully descriptive lava caverns, peering into all the holes in the Swiss cheese room, or chilling out in the soft room.
These kaleidoscopic mushrooms are trippy to say the least.
Is it just me, or does the narrator sound Australian here?
Anyway, we can't spend too much time tripping out on mushrooms. There's more treasure to find.
Wow, look at all this treasure! Now let's take it back to the well house and...
I'll just take all this booty and hide it away with me chest deep in the maze.
Crikey, that pirate stole me booty!
The pirate's den is hidden somewhere in one of the cave's mazes, which is so devious that once you enter, you might never find your way out again. There's one place called Wit's End, which is a most appropriate name as I really was at my wit's end trying to escape.
You've crawled around in some little holes and You've crawled around in some little hole. You've crawled around in some little... You've crawled around in some little hole.
You've crawled around in some little holes and wound up back in the main passage. You've crawled around in some little holes and wound up back in the main passage. You've crawled around in some little holes and wound up back in the main passage. You've crawled around in some little holes and wound up back in the main passage. You've crawled around in some little holes and wound up back in the main passage.
If you get stuck for long enough, you'll be offered a hint. The catch being that you lose points for taking one. Though wise adventurers who've learned from this guy will save first and then reload. For a save scummer like myself, it's a blessing to have so many save slots, and it's a good thing you don't lose points for saving, otherwise I'd end up with a negative score. Even with hints, there are many unanswered questions in Colossal Cave, like who's the mysterious figure waving at us through this window? Is it the ghost of a previous adventurer who got lost and succumbed to the dwarves? And what's on the other side of this great underground reservoir? If only we could take this boat and row out there.
We can take this boat.
If it wasn't in the original text adventure though, you're most likely not going to find it here. And according to Roberta Williams, it was important for them to stay true to the source as much as possible. What's so special about Colossal Cave is that it's not just a game. It's a piece of gaming history that should be preserved. Ken and Roberta talk about this in the Point and Click Adventurers podcast.
This wasn't designed from the beginning to be a AAA title. It was designed to honor history. I mean, if we tried to treat it like we were working for a museum and we were the curators or something, and we were restoring something that had been truly important to the industry.
From my standpoint, it's really to honor the Colossal Cave adventure game, the original. Will Crowther and Don Woods, the original designers, they started my career. Without them, I wouldn't be talking to you. You would have no idea who I was. I have no idea where I would be. It's a project of love and honor and homage, and means a lot to me.
There are a lot of things about Colossal Cave that remind me of the original King's Quest. There's a beanstalk that grows so high that you can climb it to reach the home of a giant. A troll that lives under a bridge who demands a treasure but can be dealt with by tempting a furry friend to help us. And a snake who turns into a winged horse when you throw a bridle on it.
Oh wait, forget about that last one.
Playing this made me feel like I did all those years ago, when I was a young adventurer experiencing these things for the first time. It's all about the joy of exploration and finding out what's around the next corner, and there are plenty of corners in Colossal Cave. It's fascinating to see how everything connects up. Like here, you find yourself looking down on the bird chamber you went through near the start of your adventure, and you can even slide down there, which I didn't realize until I watched Cressup's Let's Play. With the help of our magical friends Zizzy and Plu, we know how to get out of Colossal Cave. But how do we finish the game? We've found all the treasures, so what now?
This exit is closed. Please leave via main office.
Last time I livestreamed this game, I was going for maximum points, and very nearly made it before my lantern ran out at the last minute.
There's not much point in wandering.
Oh, no. No.
Just call it a day.
So I didn't achieve the full 350 points, but getting to the end was still a cause for celebration.
Your score puts you in Master Adventurer Class A. Over there is the exit. Have a good day.
Hello there, fellow adventurer.
Adventure Game Geek, this is Roberta Williams. Congratulations on completing the game. Now, play it again to see if you can get maximum points. And don't read the instructions this time.
Oh, Berta, I've got a player that's asking about the magic words.
You mean Zizzy?
Oh, you said it. Uh-oh. Bye, everyone.
Bye.
Well, anyway, that's it for Colossal Cave for now. If you'd like to find out more about the ancient art of text adventures, tune in next time when my friend Scott and I will be talking about the lost treasures of Infocom. Save early, save often. Yeah, look at all this treasure. Now, yeah, look at all this treasure. Now let's take it back. Wow, look at all this treasure. Now let's take it back to the well house. pirate stole me buoy! You've crawled around in some little holes and wound up back in the main passage. You've crawled around in some little holes and wound up back in the main passage. You've crawled around in some little holes and wound up back in the main passage. You won't be able to...